A mosquito surveillance trap hangs from a tree in Ringgold with a notice from the Georgia Department of Health. It's designed to catch mosquitoes so researchers can learn more about them and so health officials can monitor Zika and West Nile activity. Researchers picked this area to place five traps after Tommy Helms died from the West Nile virus last week. He lived across the street from this Clark Circle lot for more than 20 years with his wife Evelyn.
That's how he had deteriorated the fourth day. On the 27th, there was nothing left.
Evelyn is still in shock at how fast the virus took her otherwise healthy husband of nearly 66 years. She says it all started with a headache.
He pointed to the center of his forehead and he said, I've got the worst headache I have ever had and I think something has popped in my head.
Several days later, tests revealed the man known around town as Pops had become infected with West Nile. Evelyn says her husband stayed busy, oftentimes visiting the 12 rental properties they own and cutting grass.
He put a rubber band around his ankles and his shoes. Of course, he was using a rider, and we thought that was protection.
She says mosquitoes have been particularly bad this year. She believes an overgrown lot across the street may be contributing to the problem.
When you protect your home, that doesn't mean that you can protect a city block of overgrown, grassy, and debris.
Health officials may never know where the mosquito came from that infected Tommy, but that's not stopping Evelyn from sharing his story. She wants families visiting parks nearby to be on guard.
Golf cart, English hat, and enjoying Ringo.
To Evelyn, her husband will always be her Memphis sweetheart, who lived life to the fullest and adored his family above anything else. In Ringgold, Michelle Herron, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.